Hello, my name is Aaron. Today's tutorial shows how to customize page numbers in Microsoft Word. We'll then look at how to save your custom page numbers so they can be reused in future documents. We'll also look at how to delete your custom page numbers from the Page Number Style menu when they're no longer needed. I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365. These steps also apply to the recent non-subscription versions of the software. These steps don't apply to Word for Mac, Word for the web, or Word for mobile. Before we start, it's important to note that there are countless ways to customize page numbers in Microsoft Word. So, for the sake of brevity, we're only going to cover the basics of changing the font, size, color, and adding effects today. To begin, select the Insert tab. Then select Page Number in the Header and Footer group. From there, select the location where you want to insert the page numbers. The Top of Page or Bottom of Page option will be the best choices for most users. Next, choose a style that is closest to your needs from the submenu. When the page number appears in the header or footer area, select it, and then select the Home tab. Now you can choose a new font, size, or color. Or you can choose from one of the many text effects. Today I'm going to choose this pre-built purple option with a drop shadow. After adding your customizations, we need to ensure that the page number is still selected before we can save it. Then, reselect the Insert tab, followed by Page Number, and then reselect the location, such as Top of Page or Bottom of Page. Next, select Save Selection as Page Number from the bottom of the submenu. When the Create New Building Block dialog box appears, enter a unique name for your custom page number. The default settings for the remaining dialog box options should be appropriate for most users. When you're finished, select the OK button. And then double-click in the body of the text to close the header and footer areas. Note that it's normal for the page numbers in the header or footer area to look muted or grayed out when you're working in the body of the text. If we reselect Page Number and the location, we can see that the custom page number now appears in the General section of the menu for use in future documents. If you want to remove the saved page number from the Page Number Styles menu later on, once again select the Insert tab, followed by Page Number, and the location. Next, right-click the custom page number in the menu, and then select Organize and Delete from the shortcut menu. When the Building Blocks Organizer appears, the custom page number should be automatically selected. Select the Delete button, and then select the Yes button in the dialog box asking if you're sure you want to delete the selected building block. Lastly, select the Close button. And as always, remember to save your file to save your changes. All the steps we just performed are listed with images on my website at aaronwrightwriting.com, which is linked in the description box below, along with my playlist, How to Use Microsoft Word, where you'll find many related tutorials, including how to combine text and page numbers in headers and footers in Microsoft Word. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.